Hello everyone, welcome back to my channel Free Your Taste Buddy. It's time to tickle your taste bud with my unique recipes. When we think of any vegetarian starter, we use potato, baby corn or paneer. Let's see how to use a root vegetable and prepare a starter. So my today's recipe is delicious honey chili arbi. Looks yummy, right? Let's start. We need 3 to 4 pieces of arbi root, which is also known as colocasia or taro root, kesu in a gadde in Kannada. I have washed them, peeled the arbi roots and cut them into pieces with the shape and thickness same like that of finger chips. Apply oil to your hand before peeling or cutting arbi pieces to avoid finger itching. 2 tablespoons of maida or all-purpose flour, 1/4 cup of semolina or suji, 1/2 cup of corn flour, 2 tablespoons of honey, 1 teaspoon of sesame seeds, 2 teaspoons of ginger garlic paste, 6 to 7 garlic cloves finely chopped, 6 to 7 green chili sliced, 2 spoon of red chili sauce, 2 tablespoons of green chili sauce, 1 tablespoon of vinegar and 1 tablespoon of soy sauce. First, let's start with arbi fries. Take a vessel with half filled water and add the cut arbi pieces to the vessel. Cook this on medium flame for about 5 to 8 minutes and keep stirring in between. Let's check if the arbi pieces are cooked or not using a knife. Just cook the arbi pieces, don't overcook it as we will be frying them later. To a bowl, add 1/2 cup of corn flour, 2 tablespoons of maida or all-purpose flour, 1/4 cup of semolina or suji, 1 teaspoon of ginger garlic paste, salt as per taste. Mix all the ingredients and add water. Whisk it nicely so that no lumps are formed to form a smooth batter with the required consistency. Now coat all the boiled arbi pieces with this smooth batter. Let's fry them. Heat a kadai with oil on low flame. I have taken very less oil for deep frying as arbi requires very less oil when compared to potatoes. Now add the coated arbi pieces to hot oil. Fry them on low to medium flame. Keep flipping them on both the sides. As we have already cooked the arbi pieces, it will not take much time to fry. Fry until a nice golden brown color. Now you can see crispy and tasty arbi fries are ready. These arbi fries can be served as snack by sprinkling chili powder or chaat masala with tomato ketchup. Let's see how to prepare honey chili sauce. Heat a pan with 2 teaspoons oil. Add 1 teaspoon ginger garlic paste. Add finely chopped garlic. Add sliced green chilies. Saute for a minute. Add 1 tablespoon of soya sauce, 1 tablespoon of vinegar, 2 tablespoons of green chili sauce, 2 tablespoons of red chili sauce, 1 tablespoon of tomato ketchup. I'm not adding more tomato ketchup here because we'll be adding honey. Now we have to add the corn flour slurry to this mixture. Let's see how to prepare the corn flour slurry. To a bowl, add 1 teaspoon of corn flour, add 1/4 cup of water. Mix it nicely to give a thin slurry. You can see a thin corn flour slurry is formed. Add this to the sauce to give a nice consistency. Mix it well. Add 2 tablespoons of honey. You can add more as per your taste. Now add 1 teaspoon sesame seeds or til. Give it a nice stir. Add salt as per taste. Remember, you have added salt in arbi fries, so add accordingly. Sprinkle little pepper powder to give that hot and sweet taste. Your sauce is ready. To this, add the arbi fries and mix it really well. Give it a nice toss on low flame. Tasty and delicious honey chili arbi is ready to be served. Garnish it with finely chopped spring onion and sesame seeds, which is optional. Enjoy this finger-licking recipe with your loved ones. Stay tuned for my next recipe, which is on different varieties of fruit. And to know what's the recipe, please subscribe my channel. Thank you for watching. Check and subscribe my channel for more recipes.